This video tutorial I will explain how to create a user API call using Rest Assured. Here you can see Spring Boot application which exposes RESTful web services for user create, user get, user update and user delete. Here you can see RESTful web service client which is developed using Rest Assured. Using this we can send create user request to Spring Boot application which process the request and sends create user response back to the RESTful web service client. We will see the example now. Here you can see Spring Boot Rest Assured project, and here I have opened pom.xml file, and here you can see the dependencies. Here I have included Rest Assured dependency and JSON path dependency to parse the JSON response, and JSON schema validator dependency, and JUnit file related dependencies. And in Spring Boot starter dependency, we have to exclude Hamrest to avoid compatible issue with Rest Assured and JUnit. These are the things we have to do. Here you can see Spring Boot demo application which exposes RESTful web services for user create, update, user get and user delete, which is equivalent to this one. And Spring Boot Rest Assured project is equivalent to this part. Here I have defined the class test create user, and in setup method I have defined base URI and port number, and here I have defined contacts path, and in Spring Boot demo application here contacts path is defined, that I have put here. To create the user we have to send request to this URL, and HTTP method should be post, and we have to send body like this, and it has user details, first name, last name, email address, password and array of addresses. It has billing address and shipping address. Same thing we have to do in the Java code. Here I have created test create user method, and here I have defined user details map. In that I have put key value pairs like first name as Arun, last name as Kumar, email as arun@yahoo.com, password as pass123, and here I have created shipping address map, and I have added key value pairs, and here I have created billing address map, and I have put key value pairs, and here I have defined user addresses as list, and in user addresses I am adding shipping address and billing address, then I am putting in user details map, then I am using method supported by Rest Assured like given dot content type as application/json. Content type is request header and value is application/json, and request header accept as application/json, and body I am giving this one which is already constructed dot when, then I am using post method, and this URL I am sending the request, and once request goes, Spring Boot application process the request and sends the response back, and here I am checking the response status score should be 200, and response content type should be application/json, and from that I am extracting the response, and here I got the response object. From response object using JSON path I am getting the user ID value, and here I am asserting it should not be a null, and from response I am getting the body as a string, and from response body string I am getting response body JSON object. Then from that I am getting addresses, and I am asserting the addresses should not be null, and length of the address should be 2, because we are sending two addresses, shipping address and billing address, so length should be 2. And also I am getting address ID from one of the address object, and address ID should not be null, that I am asserting here. Now I am going to start the Spring Boot application. Spring Boot application is started. I am going to MySQL database. Refresh. Here you can see users table, and currently it is empty. And here you can see addresses table, and currently it is empty. Now we will run this JUnit test class. Right click, run as JUnit test. And here you can see one test case has been run, and zero errors and zero failures, and test case has been passed. This test case has been passed. Here you can see test create user method has been passed, and it took 9 seconds. And here you can see the logs of Spring Boot demo application. Request reached here, and we will check it in the database. Here you can see one user has been created, Arun, and two addresses has been created. One is shipping address, another one is billing address. Now we will analyze the test client logs. Click on console, and here you can see the test client log. This double arrow indicate request from test client to Spring Boot application, and this double arrow indicate response from Spring Boot application to test client. And here you can see we have used post method, and this URI we have sent the request, and this is the host, and content type header and corresponding value, content length header and corresponding value, accept header and corresponding value, and we have sent this JSON as request body, which contains first name, last name, password and array of addresses, shipping address and billing address. And for that we got the response as 200 OKS status code. And response headers, and here we got the response body. In that user ID is generated, and also address ID also generated. You can get Java source code link for each video in the description section of the video. Here you can see the description section. Click on show more, and here you can see the Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.